Welcome to the Full Scene tutorial. A couple reasons why I wanted to make this tutorial, as you guys might have seen on my Instagram story, I did teach a friend how to make his first scene, and I'll put that up here. And a lot of people were asking if I can help them somehow. So I thought, in general, I should make just a full scene tutorial because I can help everyone out. So I did a quick poll on my Instagram. All the people that voted yes, finally, it's getting made into a tutorial. It's happening now. Obviously, for this scene, we only have so much time. So I can't absolutely slam it with details as I do on some of my Instagram scenes, but it should still be pretty cool. So maybe by the time I've made this video, you'll see the actual final render in the thumbnail. But yeah, let's get into it. So just having a look at all the references we've got here, I generally like to lay out all my images that I collect on an app called PureRef. It's absolutely free, but you can donate to them. It's a really good app, so I highly suggest it. So I had the idea of sort of creating this temple or mystic temple scene. So I just collected a bunch of different references for that. So as you can see, we have some focusing on composition and lighting, and others sort of focusing on like the color and that part of the scene. So the ones with like the yellow lines and stuff just sort of showcase where the light is coming from, and also what parts of the foreground are shaded out. So generally I like to sort of darken the foreground of my images because it sort of draws the eye into the subject or the center of the scene. So the first idea I had with the scene was actually to make some sort of temple throne room. So I imported one of my older assets that I made a while ago for an Akira project, which never came to light. But I do try to reuse a couple assets I make every now and then because it does help to speed up the process for making scenes quite a bit. So generally I also like to start off with the textures. I don't know why, but that's just sort of how I work. I'm really drawn to textures within 3D. So that's, I usually start off with that to get inspired. So I'm sort of just similar to the concrete tutorial which I made a while ago. I'm using sort of the same techniques as I did then. So check that out if you want a full in-depth version of that, but I'm just gonna time-lapse through it here. So yeah, there's really just a lot of playing around. I will add though that I'm really thinking about what's going to fit into the scene. So as I mentioned previously, it's generally going to be a temple-ish sort of scene. So I'm trying to mix some sort of dark rock sort of aspects in. And I think I mixed two displacement maps here to sort of get my own sort of texture rather than just using a stock displacement map. But yeah, just really connect the textures you're using to the scene because that will really help amplify your story, which is the most important part of any artwork, in my opinion. So I should probably also add that a lot of the textures and 3D scans for like the rocks and stuff that I'm using here are all from Quixel Bridge. Quixel have a bunch of awesome assets for you to download and use in your projects. As you can see here, I'm making some adjustments, so I'm just color correcting these to sort of fit the dark vibe because the albedos and stuff were a bit too orange. So I'm also just taking a color ramp here and plugging that into the strength of the normal, and also just bringing up the black value so it shows more of a reflection, which can amplify the wet sort of concrete rock look that I have a lot of the time in my scenes. You can kind of sort of just kit-bash these together with the ground texture you make, and that usually works really well for realism and stuff like that. So I think at this point I sort of just decided to ditch the throne room kind of scene. I don't know what was happening to my model, but I couldn't really fix it, and no, it wasn't transmission or anything. Everything was fine with the textures. But yeah, I sort of had a different idea in mind, which is sort of how I moved into this phase, which was the light modeling phase. So I kind of tried to make these sort of Roman pillars, which you find a lot of the time in some rundown temples or something along the lines of that. So you can really refer to your reference images here. I sort of had a really good idea of what I was making. And the tip I'm using here of the beveling is just using bevel profiles on Blender. And I got this tip from Ian Hubert on his Patreon. He has some really cool stuff on there and lots of good advice. So I do usually pick up a lot of tips from sites like Patreon and everywhere on YouTube really.
So at this point, I already had like a pretty good idea of what I wanted the scene to look like. I wanted to go for some sort of dramatic panning in shot of this hallway with a really straight down composition. And yes, I know it's super simple, and I do this all the time in a lot of my scenes, which is just a straight down composition. But it really works well for stuff like this because you have these leading lines from the columns focusing on your center subject. So I'm also playing around with lighting here, and I think at this point I also add some volume. If you're struggling with lighting, I highly suggest adding an atmosphere, because sometimes that is the magic little trick that's needed to sort of make your lighting pop like you want it, and in this case it really worked here. So I'm pretty sure here I decided to just duplicate a lot of my current scans that I've color corrected from Quixel. You can really never have enough variation when it comes to your ground textures or your scene in general. The more you add and like the more detail you put into it, the more realistic and awesome it's going to look. So yeah, just play around with it until you get like a nice feel for it. So I then had this idea of adding some fire or some animated fire. And a really cool trick to do this without simulations, because simulations take freaking ages to do, and I don't want to bake that. I usually just go to a site called Pexels, and they have free stock video. So I found some cool animated or videos of fire, and then if you import that as an images as planes or video as planes in this case, you can set the keyframes of where you want the video to play, and then plugging that into the alpha of the image removes the black background and you have a really nice fire that you can use. The results in these can be really mixed, so you have to play around with it and find like a bunch of different videos to see which one works well, but in this case this one really worked, and I color corrected it to be more reddish I think later on as well. So I decided later on to do like a complete 360 of the lighting and ditch the whole side angle thing, and instantly got this nice moody shot with the top down lighting. So I really, really like this. It adds a lot more mystery and mood to the scene, so I decided to go with this for the project. This also goes to show that you can always just change up your lighting. Worst case, you can change it back, but if you don't experiment, you can't really see the potential that your scene has. So a lot of the time I do like to just completely redo my lighting and be like, okay, what other approach can I take here to make the scene look even cooler? So this part I'm just going to speed up a bunch. Basically what I did here is mainly just futzing about with all the different rock placements, and I did add some secondary lighting just to add that little spot of highlight in the foreground, or in the mid foreground, and also just mainly placing rocks. And I was also experimenting with some light animation to create this cool anti-gravity effect. I was also getting some really cool vibes at this point from the scene, and it reminded me a lot of The Lord of the Rings and The Hobbit, the Dwarven Kingdom, where the dragon is, so I did look up some references from that, but I didn't really find anything too useful. I then later found these really cool statue scans, and this really sort of brought the scene together and brought it to a new place, because it adds a lot more story and it makes it look a lot more like a tomb. That's sort of underground and abandoned, which I found really cool. So just duplicating these to every little pillar here and there, and it adds a lot more detail and variation to the scene. I'm also really trying to play around with the lighting even more, so I had this crazy idea to add these red sort of spots, because blue and red really work nicely together, but I think I later took this out because it was a bit too much for me. So lighting, I wouldn't go overboard with it, just try minimize the amount of light sources in your scene, and that will usually 99% of the time give you the best result. Just make sure there's enough light in the scene and you should be good, but it really helps with the focal subject and stuff like that. So after adding a couple more rocks to add this more dangerous sort of feel to the scene, I'm really sort of starting to focus on how the scene can make more sense. So I do head to Sketchfab and grab a model of a torch to hold the fire, so the fire's not just coming out of the stones or the pillars in the ground. A lot of the time I would model this stuff in Maya. I really like modeling as of late, but I wanted to sort of keep this simple and not go overboard with all the details, because it would just take way too long, and also Maya is something that I think most people aren't going to use. You can use Blender for modeling. Blender's great for modeling. I just prefer to use Maya because that's sort of what I've learned modeling in. But yeah, in this case we're using some Sketchfab models. It's a really great site to sort of pick up some free models and paid ones if you want to do that, but yeah, I highly recommend it. So the majority of the scene is basically done at this point. I'm really just trying to fine-tune the camera animations, add a bit of like natural wobble. It doesn't really look that extreme when it's slowed down, so it's a lot more subtle, but it really adds, all those little subtle details add to your scene at the end. And I'm also animating more of these sort of little rocks and bigger rocks to sort of float up to create this anti-gravity effect, and the idea is to have this character animated in the middle who sort of brings up these rocks, and that's kind of the story, that he's sort of rising from the Stark tomb. But yeah, we still have that to add, and a couple more details to finish up on. So my rigging process is usually pretty simple. I don't really go for like a full rig on the character. I just kind of rig the necessary parts, and with Blender I found that the auto weight generally has some good weight maps when it comes to like these characters and scans specifically. But yeah, it's usually pretty simple, and then I just animate the bones to sort of do some simple movement. But yeah, I have actually recently found that animation takes so long if you do it properly, because we did an assessment in uni for that. But I'm generally not the best animator, so I like to keep it simple here and keep the main focus on the actual scene itself. But yeah, this is really what sort of goes into my scenes. They're not always perfect, and also I left out the part where the post-production was in. So there was a lot of post-production After Effects where I color graded it, but maybe I can cover that into another video. But I hope you guys enjoyed, and yeah, hopefully you learned something.